Hi, and welcome to this class on Power Searching with Google. I'm Dan Russell, and I'm a research scientist here at Google. And one of the things I do is teach people how to become great searchers. That's what this class is really all about. So welcome. What we'll be doing in this course is talking about some of the key ideas about how to search on the internet. And so what we'll be doing is talking about the idea of search. What does it mean to actually search over the internet? What does that really mean? We'll talk about some of the key methods to improve your skills, and we'll talk about what's possible to find. So this class is really intended to make you a better searcher. It's intended to make you 10 times smarter, or at least you'll be able to search 10 times better than when you started. So what we'll be doing in this class is basically walking through a series of lessons, each lesson intending to teach you a particular skill. Here's the way it works. The classes are broken up into 6 different modules. Within each module, we'll have a set of lessons, 1 to 5 lessons. Each lesson is a roughly 5-minute video, maybe it gets up to 6, who knows. And then after each lesson, after we've shown you the idea, maybe given a few demos, we'll have an activity. I really encourage you to do the activities because that's the way you practice. And if you practice, you're going to get better. And so I really want you to take the time to actually spend a few minutes with the activities. Sometimes the activities are as simple as going and doing a search and then answering a simple question. Sometimes it suggests going off into one of the forums and adding your ideas there. I highly encourage you to do that too. So what we'll be doing after the first half of the class, the first 3 classes, we'll have a mid-class assessment. The idea here is just to allow you to test, make sure you really understand what you've been learning. And then at the very end of the class, after class 6, we'll have a final exam. One thing to notice is that each lesson will be a video of me talking. You'll see the activity that comes up after each little video lesson. And then in the upper right corner, you'll see you have access to a text version of the lesson and the slides of the lesson. So if you want those, go ahead and click on those in order to get access to them. If you notice in the bottom right, there's the next button. That will take you either to the next activity or to the next lesson if there isn't an activity for that one. So what counts in this class? What really counts is that you learn how to be a better searcher. That's really what I'm looking for, and I hope that's what you're looking for as well. But if you want the certificate, there are really only 2 things that count, the midterm test and the final test. But like I said, do the activities. They're really important. You'll be a much better searcher. I also encourage you to use the forums. These are the discussion forums that are associated with each lesson. Sometimes the lesson activity will encourage you to go write something in the forum, and really go ahead and do that because you'll learn a lot by participating in the forums, and the social aspect of learning turns out to be really important, especially in this class, which is really worldwide. Sometimes you can help out your fellow students, and sometimes you'll learn from your fellow students. So keep this in mind as you go through the class. Now notice that not all the search features I'll be showing you in this class are available globally. Sometimes we have limitations based on the country, particular regulatory requirements, and so on. But we will be listing an additional bonus video that shows you later how to get access to everything, even if you're in one of those countries that doesn't support that current version that I happen to be demonstrating at that time. So look for that. The key idea here for the entire class is that search is a skill you can learn and be better at. We have a lot of products, and there are a lot of products on the internet that all use these same core concepts of search. There is the basic one of being articulate and being clear about what you're searching for using the right search terms. There's the basic idea of how to limit the scope of your search so you can get to exactly to the thing you're looking for. And there's the basic idea of using all of these skills across all products. Google, we have YouTube, we've got images, we've got maps, we've got patents. All these skills will apply to all these different domains. So Power Searching is really a global class. So your classmates will come from all over the planet. Take advantage of that because you'll start to see that the world is big and the search results you can find from other places are often really interesting. So as an example, you can search for Google Senegal or Google Costa Rica and you'll see the local versions of Google from each of those countries. Now, throughout this course, I want to point out that you'll see these things in blue with the square brackets. like Google Senegal here. That's an example query. So you can go ahead and try that. Anytime you see blue text surrounded by square brackets, that's a query. That is, that's the thing you type into Google. Don't type the square brackets. You can, it won't matter, but it's just a signifier to show you where the boundaries of that query are. Our next lesson will be on a very cool technique about how to filter by color, and that sets up this whole basic skill of how to filter your search results to be more precise. But before you go there, I encourage you to go on to the next activity. Go ahead and try it and get into the swing of things. I think you'll enjoy it. I hope you enjoy the entire course. See you in the next lesson.